Mitchell, and I am playing Mrs. Lovett in Sweeney Todd.
Bryan Mercer, playing the judge.
So.
How's your experience been, Mrs. Lovett?
How are you going to interview me?
Well, Mr. Todd.
It has been fabulous so far. Actually, Fabrefaction is one of my favorite theaters to work at. Everybody here is always very, very kind and prepared. And I am having the time of my life with the cast of the century.
Thank you so much. This is my first time, Clint and I both. The starters of this are as an old student of mine, and the director as well. And they've hence gone to NYU and back, and hiring their old teachers. So here I am, first time here. I'm having a blast. We've been in rehearsal for 4 weeks now. We open a week from today.
Yes,
oh my gosh.
Yes, we do.
And it's gonna be a lot of fun. Nine of us are doing it all. We're not playing the instruments. We do have an incredible, incredible band, musical director. But we're not just the principals. We're also doing the courses, and we're kind of always there. So it's a very different experience for Sweeney. This is my third one I've done, and I'm loving it.
Yeah.
Loving it.
It's fun to be, bringing more Sondheim to Atlanta, because we had our Into the Works project at the Alliance, and of course Into the Woods was at the Alliance, and here we are with Sweeney, so enjoying this, submersion in Sondheim's music, which we all really love, even though it's challenging score, but that's what makes it so much fun as well. So, getting to get out some frustrations by slitting throats every night. Well, who could turn that opportunity down?
It's anger, aggression, therapy.
I guess we're all kind of villains, aren't we?
Yes.
In a way.
You're the fun one.
In a lot of ways.
Right. Taking your penchant for making pies one step further, eh?
That's right.
So, and the costumes are fabulous.
Brilliant.
Which we're going to put on this evening for the first time, so. Looking forward to that.
Looking forward. And our director has fit it into a very new and original concept, which I don't want to give away, but I've never seen a production of Sweeney Todd like this at all. So I'm very, very excited. It's an actor's version. I've seen a lot of productions where, sure, they could sing it, but the acting hasn't quite been there, or vice versa. And I think this is the first time I've really seen. Well, we don't need triple threats because we're not dancing much, but it's definitely got it going on. I think the acting is as high level as the singing and the music, which I think this piece demands it.
And to be doing it at Halloween is just an extra bonus as well.
Oh, yeah.
I think it's going to make a really devilish and scrumptious Halloween for everybody who comes to see it in Atlanta.
And it's a huge show you can be very close to.
Mm-hmm.
The audience is very... very close to us.
Right. So, and it's a great space to perform in, too. I mean, I've only been here to see a few, meetings and events and things, and I remember during the auditions, I was like, wow, this sounds good. It's a good space. So.
It's beautiful. It makes our job easy,
mm-hmm.
because you're not in a hole.
Right.
And beautiful wide stage.
A very intricate and ambitious set that's going on in there that is coming together and going to be tricked and treated out for Halloween, I think.
It'll be a big surprise, I think, when you walk in first. It'll be a big surprise. But like you said, no giving it away.
That's the play, and he wouldn't want us to give it away.
We can keep rhyming.
Well, there have been several versions of Sweeney, known and not so known, I suppose. For me, since he's had this 15-year vendetta of revenge against the judge and his compatriots, to me, revenge is a very cold emotion. Some people approach it as a fiery kind of emotion, but for me, it's a very cold and driven kind of sensation and motivation. So part of the reason I wanted to do this part is because I'm not really a fan of violent theater or violent movies, and this is a violent play, and so I had to come to terms with that. And for me, I find that vengeance and revenge and righteousness are something that's quite toxic to humanity, and so it's my hope that people get a sense of the price of revenge and what revenge actually can do to oneself and the people around one, and actually create tragedy around them. So that's kind of the way I've come at it. And of course, you know, the dark humor adds to the fun of it and helps it be not so diabolical all the time.
It's my turn. Right. I had the unique advantage of not being familiar with the show. I knew the role Mrs. Lovett. It has, you know, obviously stood on its own for a long time. But having the opportunity to do this role is a giant in one of my personal goals. And being able to step into it and just feel the integrity of it that comes from not just the way that it's written and the way that it's been done in the past, but by whom it's been done, and the memories of the people who have done it in the past are also hold up the role and have made it an enormous challenge. And it's a pleasure. And I feel that Mrs. Lovett is a little evil and a little genius and a little wonderful and a little funny.
A little sexy?
A lot sexy.
Wait till you see the makeup. I think my goal with this is to capture my audience's attention, imagination, kind of identify with the little evil corner of that everybody has inside of them, and hopefully they will both love and really despise her at the same time. And I agree with what you said about as far as, you know, vengeance and then the cold emotion, and I feel that Mrs. Lovett comes from a place of manipulation, and it's the same thing, it comes at a price. And I think that when all is said and done, especially with this production, not giving anything away, it really, really, truly shows the price and the cost of these people's actions. And I think that that's a beautiful thing. And I think it's something that we can use a lot more of. And the fact that it's wrapped in a package of phenomenal lyrics and music and actors and set, and, you know, it's really just, it's gonna be a surprise. And it's, I think that it has a lot more depth and meat to it than other versions of Sweeney Todd.
Well done, Ms. Diane. Judge Turpin is obviously the cold machine, I think, that sets it off for Sweeney and you two. From the outside in, he's obviously, you know, bureaucracy, judgment, government, all that stuff, and the abuse of power. From the inside of him is very different. No villain believes he is a villain. He believes he is doing the right thing and in love with his young ward, which borderlines on the very creepy, and sets off one of the best stories in musical theater. It's incredibly involved, and as it progresses, it just grows in its horror. I mean, it's up there with Shakespeare for me, as far as musical plots. It is that interesting. Not to mention that we get to express this in very difficult music. You know, that the music tells the story, that the story does not stop. The music is what propels it. And I'm a huge fan of that. I'm a big opera fan as well. So, love doing the villains. Love doing the villains. I hope they just hate me.
Yes.
You know, and as far as the way that the director is crafting the show, I think for those who don't know the show or those who do know the show, they, to take a line from Sweeney, will find in these once familiar streets the chill of ghostly shadows everywhere.
So. I'm convinced that you could have seen this production 100 times and still walk out of here feeling like you just saw something brand new.
Or heard something, a new musical phrase that you never caught before, a new connection. All the themes weave in and out so brilliantly. It's up there with Verdi.
And I hope it starts a trend of more, you know, more Sondheim being done in town, because, I mean, the music is so rich, and we do a lot of good musicals in this town, but now I think, you know, our talent pool is strong enough, and we have so many, you know, really capable and inspired theaters in town that I think Atlanta is really ready for some really, you know, hardcore, you know, right on productions of some Sondheim, so, you know, bring it on. We already did that show. They did that last year. It was good, too. Did you see it?